Well, thank you very much. First of all, I would like to thank you, Institut Català de Salut, for inviting us. Just to explain what is our point of view, I would also like to congratulate the previous speakers, because listening them, sometimes I have think that I have contacted them before, because they have been explaining things that I have previously speak in some presentations that I have been done in the past. So basically what I'm going to talk is about innovation and industry perspective. I'm working in the Spanish Federation Industry of Medical Technologies, and also managing, which is one of the initiatives also of the Ministry of Science and Innovation, which is the technology platform in medical technologies. Probably, as Manuel Desco has mentioned, we are a coordinator of the mega coordinators of the super coordinators, but we are working close together and we have defined an agenda. So just to start, I will start just saying who is FENIN, just to make a short introduction. I will make an introduction to the Spanish Innovation Platform in Medical Technology. We are, I don't know how many of you know about the technological platforms in Spain or in Europe. Just to mention that, for example, in Spain there are 54 technology platforms. Many of them are mirrors of the European ones. We don't have a European platform as a mirror. Probably the most the closest to us is the nanomedicine one, but we believe that for going or reaching the nano, first you have to go through the micro. So we are focusing on going from macro to micro, and later on will come the nano. Then we will check about which is medical technology, our working areas, and then I will focus on innovation and industry perspective, which are the innovation keys that we have identified where we are working, the industry concern versus other concerns, what's industry looking for, and some conclusions. Probably most of the speak has been just told before, because innovation is a world that with few keys you can really identify the gaps and try to solve them. So who is FENIN? FENIN, as you can say, is a multi-sector federation that groups manufacturing, import and distribution companies and associations of healthcare technologies. Basically, it's the association that represents all the most of the industry in Spain that is right now working in medical technologies. It accounts for around 24,000 people working and has a total turnover of 4,800 million. This is the data that from the last study, which is 2007. In the new study that we have done, but there are still no public figures, we have gone from 24,000 to 28,000 people working, and from nearly this 5,000 million to 8,000 million. Yeah, in the crisis we have increased because people normally like to live better, and we are very close to that. So you can see also here the position that Spain has in the European medical technology industry. These are data taken out from EUCOMED, which is the European association that holds all the federation industries. Spain holds the fifth position after Germany. If you think about medical companies, you have here Siemens, B. Brown, Fresenius Medical Care. They are very big companies, large companies. You also have France, Italy, United Kingdom, and between Italy and Spain, we are fighting just to see who is taking the fourth position in the whole market. And then you have other countries like Switzerland and so on. So just let me just talk about my book, the Spanish Innovation Platform in Medical Technologies. You can see mostly all the sectors that are represented. This is an artificial heart. Well, this is an echo. This is a material for regenerating bones, implants, surgeon, robotic surgeon, imaging, physiological virtual human, VPH, virtual physiological human, implants, oxygen, ophthalmics, etc. So, what is medical technology? Many of you probably are familiar. Sometimes the audience that I have doesn't really identify with me as medical. Normally they think that we are like pharma also. But I always say that when you're in a hospital, take out the pharma, and this is where we are. All you can find in a hospital. So probably this could be a medical technology. Latest technology, a peacemaker, MC player. Why not? Probably in the future, could be. I don't know. Well, medical technology is part of the health technology, which encompasses a wide range of healthcare products. So basically, it's technologies or techniques that improve the well-being, the health of the people. This is what the medical technology is all about. We have science and technologies that you can have diagnosis, you can develop less invasive treatment, etc. So just trying to make people life more comfortable, and as you get older, living better. Our working areas, we have identified, or we are working in these five areas. Technologies for diagnosis, we have in vitro, imaging, all kind of diagnostic tests and technologies you can imagine. Sorry. Technologies for surgery, that improves materials, robotics, virtuality, etc. Materials, biomedic materials, biomaterials, nanomaterials, e-health, and assisted living technologies, which is in the AAL. So, after just doing this brief presentation of the initiative, the technology platform, let's talk about an industry perspective in innovation. Innovation means planning a strategy for having a success. So, first sentence. It has been said in the previous presentations. I think has been dirty. Innovation is at the heart of economic growth and development. Without innovation, we can have growth and we can have development. I'm not talking about technology. I'm talking about innovation, which is, as Manuel Tedesco has pointed, is a different thing. Companies have yet to become more flexible. And it's true that in Spain, it's something that companies are not prepared to understand what is innovation. And I also agree with Manuel that people think that they have to innovate because there's public funding, and it's not that. You have to innovate even there's no public funding. So companies have to yet to become more flexible and adaptable. In our particular case in the medical sector, the ability to improve, as you have said, we are very close to enhance patients' lives and patients' privilege and patients' commodity to live. So in our sector, is collaboration between academia and industry, first, has to happen. Second, has to be carefully managed, because we are then talking about here the patents, the industrial property, and all these things. So we know that, and probably this is why we have created this technology platform and we are working close together with other initiatives. But it's true that companies are not yet ready to incorporate the innovation process inside the companies. Normally it's large companies who are doing, but you have to think, as Manuel also has pointed, and you can have these figures in Europe, that probably around 90% of the total industrial sector in Europe are SMEs. An Spanish SME normally has an average of 10 employees, 25 employees, and when you talk with a company and tells you, wow, you are 25, well, you are a large company. There's 25 people in Spain working, it's like, oh, it's a huge company. It's not the case. It's still a very, very small company, and they don't have time to think about how to priorize the ideas, identify ideas, do innovation. They are just working day by day. So it's something that has to be fostered, this collaboration between academia and industry. In our particular case, or in any cases, the key is to identify the needs and expectations of audience. This is the most important. It's not worth having a very clever device if there's not a need. It's not worth to develop a very clever technology if there's not a need. And it's not worth to develop this clever technology if there's not a need and you don't meet the expectations of the people that's going to use it. For example, a medical device and a professional. So we are working in it, in our sector, or any other sector can be just applied, with all these people that is around. Patients, with normally people think that are the last ones, and they should be the first ones when talking about medical technology. Imagine that you are going to be operating by a surgeon. You would like to have the best technology to make it the best, to receive the best treatment. Society has to be ready and prepared, so we are working very close to put in value the technology. We are working also with the research institutes and academia, because they know they have the knowledge and the capabilities, and we are working in this open innovation concept, because it's no worth just working and doing the in-house research. Probably better ideas are always coming from out. Yesterday I was in a conference in the Real Academia de Medicina, in the Royal Medicine Academy in Spain, and we were talking about this, discussing about how professionals from the health sector innovate. They take technologies, they have the idea, and they innovate and take a technology from another sector and incorporate it in the health one. So very important to work with them. Of course, industry has to be involved
hospitals are critical in this area because they are the ones that are using and they are the ones that identify the lacks or the complication of the system. I always say that probably a professional would like to have only two buttons, one to switch on and switch off the device, and the other just to start doing the clever thing, taking images, doing the operation, and whatever. We go in that direction. And hospitals, diagnostic centers, and clinical research facilities, they do this clinical innovation, improvements in care treatments, diagnosis, assess process, and they are very concerned about the cost and benefit. Because, again, if we as industry don't work on war and we develop a very clever technology, but which is not cost effective, probably is not going to be accepted. Because right now, if you look at the figures of the cost of the health, it's incredible the amount of money that really costs having a very good health system in a country. And the future is going to post about developing these good care treatments, good diagnosis, good assistance process, but cost benefit. Which are the industry concerns? This is a personal review, a personal point of view. We have like these actors. So industry is what is desirable to users, what the user wants, what are their needs, what is possible with the technology. Here we have the open innovation.